However, it is the execution of the withdrawal policy that's under assault, a particular failure that happened under a president who has boasted himself as a seasoned politician with over 50 years of experience. Now, next up is a story replete with Kafkaesque elements of an Iraqi soldier held as a war prisoner for 8 years. Ziad Qader Zohrab was presumed dead after 3 funerals by his family. Qader Zohrab, very much alive, recently visited his own grave. If you're confused, you're not alone. Take a look at our next report to know more.
This is the gravestone of late martyr Ziad Qader Zohrab, martyred on 20th July 1982. And this is Ziad Qader Zohrab visiting his own grave. No, this is not a ghost story. Eerie, for sure.
When I returned from Iran in Iran as part of the exchange of prisoners, my family told me that Iraqi authorities brought in a body of you. I said, how is that possible? They said, well, you can go and see it if you want. So one of my relatives accompanied me and showed me this grave. It still carries my name until now, but it wasn't a complete body.
Zohrab was a soldier serving in the 1st Regiment, 4th Brigade, 2nd Division of Iraqi Army. He was 20 years old when he was captured by Iranian forces in July 1982 in Basra during the Iran-Iraq War. When he was captured, his family was told that Zohrab had been killed.
They informed us he was missing and told us to hold a funeral for him. And we held a funeral 3 times for him. And the last time they gave us the body. Iraqi authorities told us not to hold funerals anymore because we already had done so 3 times and it would be haram. I felt terrible because I was very young and my son was just 5-month-old baby.
So when Zohrab's family began receiving letters from him after not one but 3 funerals, his family was shocked, to say the least. There aren't many words that can encapsulate the range of emotions they went through, although the family heaved a sigh of relief.
Then we had a very nice feeling. It was like that we were reborn. Then his letters started to arrive gradually, one letter per month. The letters were delivered by the Red Cross and half of the paper was filled by him and we had to fill in the other half. We had to send some letters back.
Zohrab was held as a prisoner of war for 8 years. With the Red Cross's intervention, he was able to contact his family. The exchange of letters went on till the end of the war on August 8, 1988.
I didn't know anything about the bringing of this body. We were captured in 1982 and until 1984, when the Red Cross visited us, issued identification cards for us and gave us papers to write letters for our families so they know we are captives. They did not know that I was captive. They were just given a body instead of me.
It was only in 1990 that Zohrab was reunited with his family as part of the prisoner exchange, alive and whole. The tombstone in the main cemetery of Kirkuk still bears his name, where Zohrab goes regularly to this day to pay his respects. Bureau Report, Vyond, World is One.
Vyond is now available in your country. Download the app now. Get all the news on the move.